Hi, and welcome to this Chem 1A lecture video on the classifications of matter. Our learning objectives in this video are to understand how to classify matter according to its composition, and then also to be able to describe the various states of matter based on their macroscopic and microscopic properties. So we'll start with classifying the composition of matter. Here we see a hierarchical tree describing the various types of matter by composition. The first level of separation is whether the matter is made up of one pure substance or is a mixture of multiple pure substances. Next, under the category of pure substances, we can be dealing with a single element, such as in the example here where we're looking at, looks like some pieces of copper pipe or wire, or we can be dealing with a molecular compound, such as these sugar cubes shown here. If we were to combine more than one pure substance together, we end up with a mixture. Now, sometimes when we create this mixture, we will not be able to see the different parts once they've combined. This gives us what's called a homogeneous mixture, which is demonstrated by the cup of tea shown. Tea is composed of numerous different organic chemical compounds, all dissolved within water, and we cannot see the individual particles within that mixture. On the other hand, sometimes when we combine more than one pure substance, we can clearly see the different contributing parts of that matter. This gives us what's called a heterogeneous mixture, which is shown here by a glass containing water and oil. Pure substances are much easier to study chemically because they have a constant composition. For example, any pure substance that is an element is completely uniform, being composed of just one of the possible 118 known elements. Elements cannot be broken down into simpler substances through any sort of chemical change. This is a useful distinction between compounds because compounds can be broken down into their respective elemental parts through chemical change. For example, water can be broken down into its contributing elements by passing an electrical current through a sample of water. And so here we see a depiction of both a macroscopic view of the liquid water and the bubbles of the gaseous hydrogen and oxygen being evolved, and also a microscopic and symbolic representation of what's going on inside. Now, mixtures are composed of two or more pure substances that have been combined together. And we can grossly categorize these as mixtures where we can see the individual different pure substances within that material, and that's called a heterogeneous mixture, or one where all of the different substances combine in a seamless manner, like a homogeneous mixture. And often, in order to understand a matter that is a mixture, we need to figure out its component parts and measure what different amounts there are of each of those components, because every mixture is unique. Unlike a compound, which always has the same proportional representation of elements within it, a mixture can be any quantity of the different pure substances. A few of the methods that are used to separate mixtures are commonly used in the chemistry lab. For example, here we see an image of a filtration experiment. A mixture containing a solid and a liquid that do not readily form a homogeneous substance is passed over a porous membrane, such as a piece of filter paper, such that the solid is trapped within the membrane while the liquid can flow through. This is one way of separating heterogeneous mixtures. Another common method employed in chemistry labs is the method of distillation. This is a useful method for separating out the components of a homogeneous liquid mixture. In this case, the mixture is heated gently, allowing for the substance with the lowest boiling point to form a gas, while the substance with the higher boiling point remains a liquid. The evolved gas can then be collected and cooled to separate out that lower boiling point liquid from the higher boiling point liquid. Now, this chart that we use to classify matter is not always perfectly useful in that we can also have a mixture that is heterogeneous but actually represents one pure substance. The mixture that I'm thinking of is clearly shown in this image. It is a mixture of water in its liquid, solid, and gaseous states. While understanding whether a piece of matter is a solid, liquid, or gas is fairly intuitive at the macroscopic level, it's important to understand what is going on at the microscopic level. This YouTube video shows a useful representation of how particles move within each of the three states of matter that we will be covering. The three states of matter are gas, liquid, and solid. Gases assume the shape and volume of their container and have complete freedom of motion. The particles of a gas are separate from each other, move in straight lines, and they change direction only when they collide with each other or the sides of their container. Liquids have a definite volume and assume the shape of their containers. The particles of a liquid are closely spaced, so their motion is still random, but much more limited as the particles slip past and collide with only their near neighbors. Solids have a definite shape and volume, though each particle has what's called vibrational freedom. Particles of solids are in fixed positions and collide only with near neighbors. This concludes our video on classifications of matter. Thanks for watching.